Welcome to the next video in our guide to learning how to sell online with WooCommerce. My name is Cal Evans, and I'm a WordPress and PHP expert. And in this video, we'll learn the steps for putting your products into WooCommerce, adding variations, so you can start selling. Before we start, just a quick reminder, you can download the PDF guide at the URL given in the description of this video. In it, you'll find a more detailed explanation on this topic, as well as the rest of the steps for starting to sell online. So, let's begin. A store owner often thinks of a product as a physical thing, something they made or bought and are reselling. E-commerce can also be used to sell services and virtual products. Physical products, such as widgets, services, such as coaching, consulting, translations, and anything you do for someone else, and virtual products, which can be anything from ebooks to MP3 files to videos or PDFs of love poetry. Products have attributes that are important to the sale, such as sizes or colors. I suggest you take your first 10 products and list them out on a piece of paper. Now, add attributes for each product. Now that you have a list of your products and attributes, let's put the first product into the system. Log into your website, and on the left-hand side in the admin menu, click on Products and then Add New. Now, if you're familiar at all with WordPress, then this should look really familiar. The first thing you do is enter a product name. The next field is the large text area for you to enter your product's description. Next, we make sure that we're entering a simple product because our awesome widget is just that, a simple, single product. Next, we enter our SKU, or Stock Keeping Unit. This is your internal identifier for this product. Since this is a physical product, go ahead and enter the weight and dimensions so that WooCommerce can help calculate shipping. Next, I'm going to add an image for this product so that when people see it, they get excited enough to buy it. Finally, I'm ready to publish. Then, I can click on the permalink and see the actual product page. Many of you will have variations for products. This might be color. If, for example, we want to sell the same widget, but we want to sell it in gray, tan, and light blue, we wouldn't want to enter three different products. Thankfully, WooCommerce handles this for us out of the box. But you have to think it through before starting. Let's go through the process of adding variations to a product. The first thing you need to do is to create an attribute that changes. In our case, we'll call it color. Navigate to Products and then Attributes from the WordPress admin panel. Enter the name of the attribute. Again, in our case, we'll add color, and then click the Add Attribute button. Next, I click the Configure Terms link so that I can add the colors that we want to offer. In this case, I'll add red, blue, and green. As you can see now, we have an attribute called color with three terms. I am now ready to create a variable product that uses these colors. To do this, I start by clicking on Product and then Add New to add a new product. I give the product a name. I give my product a description. Then I go down to the product data area and I change simple product to variable product. I click on the attributes tab and use the drop down to select the color attribute we just created. And then I click add. Check the box that says visible on the product page and the box that says used for variations. Next, I select the Variations tab. In the drop-down option that says Add Variation, I select Create Variations for All Attributes. Then I click Go. This creates three versions of our new awesome widget. Now that I have three versions of my awesome widget, I can customize the attributes of each version, including things like the price, the SKU, and the image. Once I'm happy with all the settings, I click Save Changes. Once I'm happy with the entire product, I click Publish, and then I can view the product with the permalink. As I view the variations, the different settings change, like price and image. Congratulations! You've successfully added your first variable product to your online store. Now, once you get your first few products into the system, you'll begin to understand the different options available to you. The PDF guide that accompanies these videos goes into detail on several other attributes you can select and options you can set. Now, I want to hear from you. Which kinds of products would you like to sell? What would be their variations? Leave me a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click on the subscribe button on your screen to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the bell icon also so that YouTube will notify you every time we release a new video. Finally, follow us on social media to stay updated about all the news, trending comments, and resources for successful website management that we share. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.